Israel. Attack and counter attack. In this kind of marriage, they put things in record. At this stage, couple are just self-made. They are just
selling.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But what are the killers of peace in the marriage? The Song of Solomon 2:15 says. Song of Solomon 2:15 says. Take all the foxes, the little foxes, that spoil the vine. For one finds a tender grace. Let us now address this thing, something that makes marriages difficult. Number one, poor spiritual life. Poor spiritual life. Failure to give God a chance in our life, we have vexed our marriage. Adversely. And that's why I said the other time that we need Jesus Christ in our home. When we depart from God and demonstrate the work of flesh, so that marriage will not stand. When the flesh dominates such marriage, that marriage will deteriorate and become a battlefield. If you want peace in your marriage, you must give room to the Prince of Peace. If anybody wants peace in their life, in their marriage, give room to the Prince of Peace to reign supreme in your life. So he said we should allow light to come into the darkness of our family. When we read Genesis 1:1-5, we tell us more about that one. We need the light in our home. When the light is dwelling in your home, darkness will not have a place. So poor spiritual life is number one. If you are not in spirit, if your family, your both husband and wife and children, they are not in, they did not have Christ, there will be no peace in that home. Another point I want to quickly mention is ignorance. Proverbs 14:1 says. Proverbs chapter 14:1. He said, every wise woman battleth with, buildeth his house, but the foolish plucketh it by her hand. Ignorance is a major killer of marriage. Many couples lack basic knowledge of what makes their marriage work. They behave so ignorantly that we wonder whether they ever attend any school. Or they see the four wall of iron
institutions.
So, because of the ignorance, many of them fight themselves, beat themselves anyhow. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, ignorance is a killer to the joy of home. Business, when you are too busy, our schedule of business and priority may stand against our marriage. You are too busy to create time for your family. You are living dangerously. Make your spouse and your family your top priority.
And
the question they had is the other time that the woman that is so busy with his phone or with his internet. Make your spouse, your family, your children, make them number one priority. Time is the currency of marriage. Find time to spend with your wife, with your spouse, so as to bring peace into our home. So, number one, I talked about poor spiritual life, that we need Jesus Christ in our home. I say ignorance is a killer to the marriage. I talk about business. When you are so busy and you don't allow peace, you don't allow, there's no time for your home. I want to talk about number 4 because quickly. Taking each other for granted. Taking your spouse or your wife, your husband for granted. It is easy to take your spouse for granted. It is very easy to own deeply those we love so dearly. Many respect strangers and visitors and neglect their spouse. They respect their friends, they respect their husband friends, and they have no respect for their own husband. Many people talk carelessly. Many people dress shabbily. Because I have married now, I have children, I don't need anything again, and they dress shabbily. Many did not appreciate their husband, they did not appreciate their wife. Many embarrass their wife or the husband openly and remove the veil of reverence. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And there will be room for aunt and misunderstanding in that family. There will be room for hatred and offenses in that family. And that one will lead to bitterness all the time. Third party.
They may
mention something like that when we are asking questions. For the marriage to be peaceful, it must involve only two people. The moment you involve the third party, marriage becomes another thing entirely. You should know that your sibling, your children, your friend, no matter how close they are to you, they are just third parties. They are part of your family, but not part of your marriage. You should not allow them to influence you against your spouses. Don't hand over your marriage to any people outside. No matter how close they are unto you, you should not expose the secret of your marriage. When there's fine, make sure you find ways of all possible means of settling dispute within yourself. Let me stop by making mention number six. Because of the time. Ineffective communication. Couples who take deeply or lovingly or openly, joyfully and truthfully together with his wife or with their spouses.
There's
no dark room within the two of them.
There's
no secrecy among them. No lies, no unfaithfulness. No abusing words against your spouse. No ambiguity, no slander. No nagging or no other negative words. Communication is the mother of all human relationships. So when it is not done right, it means it's not done at all. So every couple should guide their communication jealously. Colossians 4:6 says, be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. Let there be an effective communication within among the spouses. To bring peace to our home, to bring happiness to our home, there must be an effective communication. We have been saying a lot since the time of questioning and answer. So I want to pray concerning our home, that God Almighty will establish our home. I pray God will establish our home. Joy and happiness will begin to flourish in our home in the mighty name of Jesus. Enemy will never prevail over our home. So shall he be in the mighty name of Jesus. Shall we stand up on our feet? Thank you for patience. We have a lot of things to pass across, but there is no time. We do that in other time. I want us to say, Father, uphold my family to the end. Uphold my family to the end. Let's pray that prayer very well. That you uphold my family. Uphold my family, O Lord, to the end in the mighty name of Jesus. Uphold me and my family, my wife, my husband, my children. Let there be understanding. Let there be peace. Let there be joy. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let there be faithfulness in our family. That he help us, O Lord. Uphold our family to the end. Don't let us fall. Don't let us fail. Don't let us falter. Pray that prayer very well. Pray that prayer very, very well. That you uphold my family. Uphold me and my wife, my children. Let there be peace, let there be joy, let there be happiness in our home. Daddy, let it be so in the mighty name of Jesus. Eternal, immortal, we want to appreciate you once again. We want to give you thanks and praises because of the opportunity given unto us this afternoon to expose the secrets that have bring bitterness, hatred into our home. Daddy, we thereby decree and declare that there be joy, let there be joy in our home in the mighty name of Jesus. Daddy, uphold our family to the end in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that you need to do to correct our lives and our family, Daddy, let it, Daddy, do so right now in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, eternal God. In your kingdom, Lord, Daddy, cast us to reign with you. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. As you are sitting down, let's begin to appreciate God for what he has done today in our family. Appreciate him. Give him thanks. Give him praise.